Hey guys, it's early in the morning and it's snowing a bit today, but I'm enjoying this walk. I'm going to the gym and I want to show you a little bit of my training today. So we'll see what works and just how it goes today. I have to try to get back on YouTube. Baby steps, but check out this beautiful place. Amazing view. So yeah, let's do this. So the plan today is a good stretching routine and then handstand. And yesterday I did strength training, like heavy shoulder pressing and pull-ups and stuff. So maybe today a bit lighter on the handstand. We'll see. If I have power, I'll just go for it again. But stretching first. Let's try to do some epic, some nice flexibility stuff. So getting started here, I always start with some front hip thing and front split. So just like a hip and front split combination. It can be, you know, other ways to do it, but now I like this. Do it like with the wall. And then I moved into pike, and I want to show you here, like now I'm really trying to work with my knees more in almost, you know, in all the stretches where it makes sense. So I'm really trying to extend the knee. Hopefully I can make more progress with my knee extension. And then I moved into this, just split warm up on both sides. Just getting ready for the splits with this, like prep stretches. And I felt I had to warm up my back a bit. I don't always do that. And this one I felt was good. So here's the first splits. I'm doing like just middle split at this point, or I do like one of each. So like front split two. So today I did front split two. This is for knees. I'm just trying to, you know, push my knee a bit and trying to understand the knee thing more. And there's so many ways to stretch knees I'm figuring out, but I don't do them all every time because it's quite taxing actually for your like energy to stretch your knees, I find. So a bit every day is my approach now. And this is a nice thing you can do for your like toes. You just double wrap the band and you put it around, and it's a little stretch, extra stretch for your point. So I do some stretches here with one leg high. And after this I did front splits. Just one, like one sequence per side, but my phone died, so I only got this. So yeah, I always now try to do some standing, like moving through the splits stuff. Like I do it almost every time I stretch, just one set at the end. And I find it just fun. And you know, today I wanted this to be good, you know, because it looks cool, but today it was actually pretty hard. But I'm having fun with it, so I guess it's kind of like a active, well, it's not really active, but it's still like a nice thing to do after you stretch. Then I just did like quick shoulders and back. So this and the bridge. This is the second set of bridge, and the first set was just so bad. Like my bridge just gets worse and worse, but I'm trying to work with it. Yeah, and I always stretch elbows just like a little bit, one set.
So I did my stretching and I'm taking 5 minute break with this carrot. And then I'm gonna do a handstand.
So this is my first handstand of the day, and that's normally just holding in the handstand and some reps of straddle. Then the next set is tucks, some form of tucking, or where your legs go behind you to like challenge the shoulder. And I use that band around my elbows to help straighten my elbow. Sometimes I use it. Then it's like the one arm warm up set. And if I would feel good, I would just go straight for short one arm holds. But today I felt I needed some more fingertip stuff. Then the next thing I did is actually one set of switches. And I don't expect much improvement from one set, you know, it's a bit hard to improve that way, but it's more fun to enter that, just wake up your balance. And yeah, it's actually pretty nice. And then if I would train switches later in the training, it's like it's already there. So then I move on with my warm up, and the next thing is usually this, which is tuck to straddle to full. And on the left I'm using some finger assistance. And more and more in my training, I'm adding small things to the sets. So I'm just adding on to it, you know, some flagging here. And then I'm trying a full position. Yeah. I didn't get like a long hold there. Sometimes I am able to hold it a bit longer, but full position is still, it's still very hard for me on floor. And then here too I add, you know, just more time under tension. I could even add more. The next thing I did was one set of straddle flag. Then just to get this out of the way, I did this assisted flag reps, and around a week ago I started to do it again, just at least one set per training, and it's really helped my flags, I think. So yeah, it's definitely good to do. And on left tuck is like super hard, so I do in straddle. This set is something I watched Marcinowski do in Kyiv, and it was just incredible to watch him do. It was something like this. So sometimes I just try to copy this set and have fun with it. Yeah, and now I'm doing some more balance stuff, so some combinations, or I could also do more switches at this point in my training, but today I didn't do switches. So some figa or straight or transitions, something like that. Or if I would be training act, my act, I would do it now. Maybe. I find Figa on floor is like, it's easier to get the legs down on cans. It's just Figa on floor is not working well for me lately. But I don't train much Figa. I train mostly flags. This is just like a couple sets. And then flags is my priority now. So after this we move on to flags. Because I think getting stronger at flags is... it's just so important, and that's what I want to focus on. And today I'm not doing any one arm press. I did some one arm press training yesterday and heard earlier in the week. So, but I would do it now, you know, after this balance around the. Now I'm doing flags, but I would do one arm press around this time if I would be training it. So I used to have like a very specific flags, you know, I do this and this flag in this order, and then conditioning, like I've tried making plans, and now I'm just more like just enjoying it and trying to, I just do what I feel like, and trying to hold it for longer, trying to clean everything up, and yeah, it's enjoyable to train like that. Yeah, but I think it's getting a bit better, a bit stronger. I believe this was my last flag for today. And then after this, I move on to lower to crook, lowering to crook. So I did a few warm-ups like this, I went to arms, then I went for it. Yeah, didn't get it today, but on cans it's easier, and yeah. So this is the end of my training, and sometimes I would do more switches here, or sometimes I do this kind of endurance, or you know, this short holds back and forth. And I just didn't feel like switches today, so I did a set of this, just going back and forth, back and forth. And then after this I would do, you know, presses or handstand push-ups or stuff like that, planche. But today I'm not doing any of that. Because I'm just, yeah, yesterday I'd had strength training yesterday, so this was my last set for today.
Okay, so I finished my training, almost 4 hours, and that time went by so quick because I was focused on, you know, filming and stuff, and it's all new to me. So yeah, there's someone I follow and he said that, you know, you consume all this content, why can't you make a video, you know? And that got to me. So, and I used to be really into making videos, but for some reason I stopped. And yeah, I don't know, maybe I'll try to post something once a week, it's my new goal, but we'll see, you know, one day at a time, one video at a time. So yeah, training was pretty good. You know, I do everything on floor now because I don't have canes right now where I am, so training just on floor can be a bit not as fun because it's hard and you don't get that variety and feeling that you can just do tricks on canes. But I feel like I'm making progress for floor, and then I know when I go back to canes it's going to translate into just stronger combinations and just a new level on canes. So it's good. Now it's starting to snow again. But yeah, thanks for watching. I hope, you know, it was valuable or entertaining, or for someone, if you made it this far into the video, you're one of very few. So yeah, everyone have a great day, and yeah.